I'm your host, Olivia Winston here, hot on the mic and live on Zoom, keeping you woke on the topic. You have officially entered the
No Snooze Zone.
Do you ever dream of being a socialite and living the life of luxury? Do you wish the housewives of Beverly Hills were your best friends? Well, you're not alone. Today's special guest will tell us how he made his dreams of rubbing elbows with the Bravo celebrities a reality. Let's go on a journey and take our first steps behind the velvet rope with David Yontef. Welcome to the studio, David.
How are you?
I'm doing well, David. Did I jack up your name?
Perfect.
Ah, I got it.
How are you?
I'm doing well, David. Word on the street is you have the hottest show out in New York right now.
You know what I think it is? I think so. My podcast, Behind the Velvet Rope, it's really Bravo-centric. So I tell people, listen, it deals with some reality TV, 10%. But the bottom line is, if you love Bravo, you're going to love my podcast.
Are we going to be seeing Behind the Velvet Rope on Bravo soon?
Wouldn't that be nice? I mean, you're going to be seeing it in a few things. I just wrote a book, Behind the Velvet Rope, so there's going to be a book that corresponds to the podcast. And I mean, really, the whole genesis of the podcast was I went from a fan to a friend. I was a fan of Bravo. I was a fan of the Housewives. And just one day, you know, living in New York, they come to New York to do press. We have New Jersey, New York, and one day I just said, you know, I want to insert myself into the story. I don't want to just sit around and talk about this all the time. So I really set out on a journey to become friends with the people on Bravo. And there's a process to it. It doesn't happen overnight.
Okay.
But yeah. It happens.
I have questions about that.
Okay.
What I want to know is, who are some of the biggest stars that you've had on your show?
So we have had on, you know, from the Bravo world, we've had the OG herself, Ms. Vicki Gunvalson. We've had Sutton Strack from Beverly Hills. We just had Marlo Hampton on from Atlanta. Marlo's a good. I love Marlo so much. Vanderpump, we've had on Sheena Shea. We've had on Charlie, who was a newbie, who's not so big, but that our highest rated episode ever was Charlie. She just sat there. She talks about how she was treated by the OGs. The OGs were not so nice to Charlie. Stassi and all of them were not so nice. So we had Charlie on. So listen, we really try to, I don't want to focus on any one particular show. Literally, I want to give people something to choose from.
What's your favorite Housewives series?
You know, I live in New York, so I have to say New York. It's just like, it's what I can relate to because it's like my backyard. So like, I get how, you know what I mean? Like in New York, the New York girls drink more than any other because that's how it is in New York. Everyone's single. Everyone goes out. So it's just like, it's what I know. New York
when everything calms down with Corona.
Seriously.
Let me ask you this. Who was someone that you were most surprised by? Like, who is someone that you interview or that you had the opportunity to meet who's not at all like the character they portray?
That is a good question. I feel like I'm trying to think because there's definitely been moments like that. Well, for instance, I don't know if she's so different, but like, for instance, Charlie, I'm just going to use her. So like Vanderpump Rules, the smallest person on the TV was Charlie. So to me, I was like, she's barely on the TV. I don't know. I'm not going to do the interview, but I wasn't excited. And so then I start talking to her and she was nice, but then she starts telling me this one treated her this. So it's like, that was an interview where I wasn't so excited and it was just so juicy. The more she talks, she's like, this is what Stassi did to me. This is what, and I'm like, oh my God. Like,
She probably had information that you had never even seen aired.
That's the thing. And so, like, it just goes to show you, don't judge an interview by its cover. I was like, this isn't going to be that exciting. I was like, this is, like, one of the most interesting interviews we've had to date. So I think sometimes, like, I misjudge who's going to be, like, such an interesting, juicy interview. And I have to say, Sheena from Vanderpump Rules 2 is a lot smarter than she seems. Like, she's a businesswoman, smart, she's kind of in on the joke. She gets her edit. She's always boy crazy. So Sheena kind of shocked me as like, this girl's really, really smart. And I didn't really expect that from watching her on TV before I interviewed her.
I love the Housewives of Atlanta. Do you have any favorites on that show?
I don't know if this is going to be a popular opinion. Marlo is phenomenal, but the gift from above is Miss Kenya Moore. And also, I think this past season of Real Housewives of Atlanta is the best it's been in years.
I'm telling you, it was hot. I've never been that locked into the Housewives of Atlanta before. I loved them before, but this year I'm like, oh, I cannot wait for next season.
So I had Yovana on my show, the one that everyone thought was the snake. I had Shiana, the cookie lady. She came on my podcast. So I think there was a lot of like between Yovana, Shiana, and like Tanya. Like, I think like the side characters, not them. There was a lot of that. It was a great season. Yeah,
I do want to see Marlo come back, and I want her to have a peach.
She said on my show, she thinks that someone doesn't like her in like the corporate set. I mean, I forgot the exact word. I have to go back and listen to my actual podcast, Sit Down with Marlo. But she said something on my show about that like she thinks someone doesn't like her at like the Bravo corporate offices, and that's why she'll never have a peach.
You're hanging with some pretty shady girls. I just want to know, where do you fit in?
People think it's like so glamorous. Oh, you're friends with all the housewives. Let me tell you, I don't love all the housewives. When you have housewife A over here and housewife B over here and they don't get along, and you're like, I love you and I love you, I'm not in the middle of this. I'm not on the show. I mean, put me on the show and give me a paycheck.
Oh, God. But short okay. of that, how did you make your way in? Give me some tips, okay?
Well, not to shamelessly plug my book, which is not out on the shelves yet, but this is why I wrote a book, because I truly was a fan watching Bravo. There's a lot of podcasts out there that just sit around and they just recap the shows. And to me, I don't really get that. I'll just watch the show. And so to me, it was like, I don't understand that. I don't need to sit around and talk about something I just saw on TV for 7 days. I kind of want to insert myself in this action. So I made a conscious decision. I'm going to become friends with these people. Listen, we're not talking about Brad Pitt and Angelina Jolie here. Like, it's not like they're inaccessible with bodyguards and living behind. I mean, they're reality stars. They're normal human beings. So one day I was just like, I am going to set out. And it's a process. Literally, this is in my book. My book is basically called From Fan to Friend. It's how to go from being a fan to a friend. And then I took it one step further and now I have a business. But you too can become friends with all these people if you read my book. It really is a how-to book. And it doesn't take a day. It doesn't take a week. If you want to put in the work and follow this book, you can become friends with anybody on reality TV.
Well, this book is going on the Olivia reading list then.
It really is. It really works. It's not a joke. You just have to really, and it's peppered in with stories and like things when I get myself into trouble with all these people. So there's some stories in there too.
So you fit in simply because you made room for yourself.
I made room for myself. Well, that's exactly what I did.
There you go. Cover some very juicy topic, and it's drawing in some pretty messy fans. I was stalking your IG page and I saw some of the messy comments, and I just want to know, how do you deal with the messiness?
First of all, because I saw those comments too, a couple of things. You know, The Sun is a major newspaper, The Daily Mail, People Magazine, Us Weekly. They're the ones quoting my podcast. So if everyone wants to leave a messy comment and say that it's old news, well, People Magazine and Us Weekly and the Daily Mail, all these major publications, apparently they don't think it is because they're citing my podcast. I'm not forcing them to write about my podcast. So they could think it's old news and I'm just going to deal with all the national press that I'm getting. Thank you very much. That's the first thing.
Hold on. Let me snap for you.
Right? Okay. I mean, okay. Okay. But here's the thing. I really have to say, So if you are a happy person in your life, I don't understand online negativity. I just don't understand it. Because if you're a happy person, you just don't go there. So I don't know if people are just so unhappy or they're insecure and they want to say something witty and then get accolades like, oh, you're so funny. I don't understand all that. And not even on my page, just on every page.
Anyone's page. They're watching. They're watching.
Yeah. But it's true. Like, listen, what's that saying about like a hater is really your fan or something? It's true. Like if someone's watching, well, you know what? It's true. It's also sometimes people will comment and it's mostly love that I get, but sometimes people will comment and be like, oh, like I just interviewed Harry Dubin from Real Housewives of New York. And someone will be like, I hate Harry. And then they'll be like, I can't believe these horrible, all these horrible things he said during your interview. And I hate him. And I'm like, you just cited something in the beginning of my podcast, the middle and the end. So I'm glad you hate this man so much because you just listened to the whole damn podcast.
Listen to the whole podcast, okay?
Thank you for the download. Thank you.
That is the strategy.
I hope you hate everyone that I interview, as long as you listen.
Okay. David, you've made it. You've made it behind the velvet rope. How does it feel? You're in there.
So 90% of the numbers in my phone are Bravo celebrities. I feel it's kind of like if you're born to famous parents, like Demi Moore and Bruce Willis's children. It's all you know. So like at some point in your childhood, you realize like, huh, my life might be different than others. So I'm not comparing myself to Rumor Willis, but I'm just saying like when something becomes your norm, you kind of need to remember like, oh yeah, like this is kind of a big deal. It just becomes my norm. And I'm like, oh yeah, like I'm like, you know, texting with, you know, Tamara Judge now. And, you know, I'm DMing Sheena and this. And I'm like, oh yeah, like this isn't really a normal life, I guess. So, I mean, it feels good, but it's really just at this point about work. Like I really like bringing my, like when someone says like, that was a great episode of your podcast or something like that's rewarding to me.
David, we want to be like you. I know I want to be like you. I want 90% of my contacts to be celebrities. Can you tell us what does it take to get behind the velvet rope? What does it take?
It takes lots of coffee, lots of energy, and lots of hard work. And okay, you know what it also takes? These Bravo celebrities, you have to have a thick skin. They are high fucking maintenance. They're drama in real life. Someone called me yesterday. I'm just like, oh, I'm not even listening. Like you're going on about the smallest thing that doesn't matter in the world. You have to have a really healthy ego and self-worth because you are like this big. It's just all about them. It's like, can you ask me how I'm doing today? If you're insecure or you need coddling, it's not about you. Really, I feel that way about almost every Bravo celebrity I'm friends with. It's about me a little bit to varying degrees, but most of the time you're along for like whatever you want. Like you're happy. Now you're happy. Okay. Are you happy back there? Is everyone happy? Are we over the drama? Oh, yeah. We all just have a drink. And then 20 minutes later, there's something else. And it's just like, nobody asked me how I'm doing today, but I'll talk about myself some other time. It's fine.
Well, I want to know how you're doing today.
Thank you.
It's time to shift gears. We're not done with our conversation just yet. Let's get ready for that midday mix, Cleveland.
It's the remix. Doja.
That's my day. Not a moment. Keeping me in the moment. I bet you had a moment. Why don't you say so? Didn't even notice. No punches that to roll. You got to keep me focused. You wanna say so?
Every time I take a break, the game be so boring. Pretty like Naomi, Cassie plus Lorman. Like Weezy, Foxy plus Lorman. Boy like the Ramsey, now that's Gordon. They don't understand the back talk I'm forming. When they think they top the queen, they start falling. Word to my ass shots, I'm so cheeky. Got them trying to palm my ass like young Kiki. Yes, I'm ghetto, word to Geppetto. Plus I'm Leto, where's my stiletto? Tell Mike Jordan, send me my retros. Used to be bite, but now I'm just hetero. Ain't talking medicine, but I made a morphine. Ever since I put the cookie on quarantine, he know this thing A1 like a felony. All he gotta do is say the word like a spelling bee.
Didn't have the moment, keeping me in the moment. I bet you had a moment, why don't you say
your face. And that hurt my shit sweet. Now these don't click in the taste. I like these new chicken. You can spin a shop and spree your chicken. You need to low key. Don't be in the seat. In the cream. But you need in me. Type I need in me. Ain't fucking with these hoes. But they're busy. I'ma hit your mind, Donna. I'm a boss ass bitch. Call me Big Mama. Bitch. Chain B Chanel. The panties pink Prada. If that nigga don't pay, then he ain't about nada.
Bounce like a motherfucking 6'4", 6'4", slick talk. Sitting that Crisco. Drop that shit like a troll at the Dove Show. Then you hit the switch and pick it up and let the world know. Homie, if you broke, oh, no, you don't deserve hope. So these fake bowlers only getting on my nerves. So I just crack the border now, sipping out the straw slow. Little bit of ratchet, little bougie, you should all know. Everybody got opinions dead like assholes. You ain't gotta worry about those, cause they assholes. We just came to party, 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 what you came for?
My breath right quick. He ain't never seen it in a dress like this. He ain't never even been impressed like this. Probably why I got him quiet on the set like zip. Like it, love it, need it, bad. Take it, own it, steal it, fast. The boy stop playing, grab my ass.
Acting like you shy.
Shut it, save it, keep it, push it. While you beating round the bush and knowing you want all this woman. And titties.
Jump off. Oh. Goons in the club, case something jumps off. You back up for the hive, let the pump off. In the graveyard is where you get dumped off. All we wanna do is party. And buy everybody at the bar Bacardi. Black Barbie dressed in Bacardi. I'm trying to leave somebody's Ferrari.
See my hips, big hips, so try. See my butts and my lips, don't try. Lost a few pounds in my waist, oh yeah. This the kind of beat that go ba-ta-ta. Ba-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta. Sex me so good, I say blah, blah, blah. Boy, oh boy, it's good to know ya.
Is it worth it? Let me work it. I put my thing down, flip it and reverse it. It's your primitive and wet, yeah, come. It's your primitive and wet, yeah, come. If you got a big, let me search it. To find out how hard I gotta work, yeah. It's your primitive and wet, yeah, come. It's your primitive and wet, yeah, come.
Come on, bounce.
You ain't no make you come. Big ghetto booty, bougie, choosy. Ain't giving up the pussy for a dinner in a movie. I need me a nasty ass nigga that don't care. Struggle with my ex cause I had the nigga scared. You ain't eating what you here for. Baby, I'm a nympho. Known to keep a nigga on rock like a Flintstone. Real freaks don't trip, they come in damn deal. Treat them like party favors, I pass them like chips. Get my nut, damn what? I'm back to business. A good lick and a trick, that's all that he did.
Call them Nestle, they crunchy, man. Ride them like a cowgirl, I'm a country fan. Ain't talking medicine, but I made a morphine. Ever since I put the cookie on quarantine, like a relay race. When I run up in the spot, bitches know they place. Slide on a nigga, I'ma need my skates. Social distance, I'ma need my space. I done did it, I won with it. I made peace with myself, at one with it. I can't let that goofy nigga come dumping it. I told boy, shoot it, shot, bust guns in it. I mean, I know that you feeling me, I could tell that you feeling me. Acting like you was getting me, boy, you really be killing me. How you digging me, igging me? Boy, you gotta be shitting me. Is you like a comedian? You gotta be kidding me.
Day and night and moment, keeping me in the moment. I let you had a moment, why don't you say so? Didn't even notice, no punches back to roll it. You got to keep me focused, you wanna say so?
You could've said so. Boy, you should've said so. Say, say.
David, it's been such a pleasure just talking with you and having you on my show. You are one of the largest profiles I've ever featured on my show. Thank you. I feel like I'm getting a step closer to wherever I'm trying to go. You are a star.
That's so nice. You're too nice. Thank you.
Thank you, David.
I really appreciate it.
Before we get out of here, what are some of your final comments that you have to share with my audience members?
I think, you know, and I say this in my book, which is not out yet. Really, you should treat everybody like they're a Bravo celebrity. You know, the goal of my book is how to become friends with the Bravo celebrities and all these famous people. But really, you know, the next Bravo celebrity and big star could be right in front of you. So treat everyone as if they are a Bravo celebrity. Treat everyone as if they are a superstar. Because you know what? One day you'll wish you had. So just treat everyone with kindness and respect. And my other advice is everyone be safe during Corona. And my other thing to say is go to Apple and go to the Behind the Velvet Rope podcast if you like Bravo and reality TV, and find the Behind the Velvet Rope podcast and listen. It really is fun.
Let everyone know where they can find you on Instagram.
The show account is Behind Velvet Rope. There's no the in it, just Behind Velvet Rope. Or you can find my personal account, which is David Yontef, just Yontef. But go to Behind Velvet Rope. It's easiest. It's a little picture of me with the housewives. And follow us. And I really do respond to DMs. So if someone slips, you know, not even in that sense, just if you write to me, chances are I'll write back to you.
Thank you so much for responding to me and connecting with me. It really meant a lot. It really meant a lot to me.
And thank you.
If you enjoyed today's conversation and you're interested in hearing more woke topics, follow me. Down.
Crowd screaming.
Now, snoozing over the long weekend. Because we all know
when you snooze, you lose.
Stay woke.